long run average cost curve part 2. We shall develop a simple model to derive long run average cost curve. In our simple model, a firm decides to have 3 plant sizes in the long run when it goes for expanding the output. Small size plant in the short period 1, medium size plant in short period 2, and a large size plant in short period 3. When it moves from one plant to another, it uses the average cost curve of that plant. To begin with, the firm is working with small size plant. It uses its average cost curve ACAC1. As the firm increases the output, the AC falls and then rises. It is beneficial for the firm to operate on small size plant till it produces M2 level of output. For example, take output M1. The average cost of producing this output with the small size plant is M1A. Whereas, the average cost of producing the same output with medium size plant is M1B. M1A is less than M1B. It means the average cost is less if the firm uses small plant. Once the firm crosses the output M2, the firm must bring the medium size plant into operation. This will enable the firm to produce goods at less cost. For example, average cost of producing M3 output with medium size plant is M3E. Average cost of producing the same output with the small size plant is M3F. It is higher than M3E. To expand the output beyond M2, the firm has to go for the medium size plant. It can use the medium size plant till it produces M4 level of output. Beyond that, with medium size plant, it can produce a larger output at a high average cost. Instead, it is better the firm to prefer the large size plant. Output M5 can be produced at a cost of M5G with large size plant. If the firm uses medium size plant, it has to incur an average cost of M5H. This is greater than M5G. Thus, the firm, by expanding the plant size, tries to produce a larger output at a minimum possible average cost. Now, how to obtain the long run average cost curve? Understand, SAC1, SAC2, and SAC3 are short run average cost curves of 3 short periods. These 3 periods at a stretch becomes a long period for the firm. Ultimately, these curves are all the constituents of the long run average cost curve. We are going to derive the long run average cost curve from these 3 curves. Just draw a smooth curve enveloping all the 3 curves. LAC is the long run average cost curve. We shall meet again in long run average cost curve part 3.